Go ahead.
The top three ways to leverage Facebook Messenger automation and chatbots for every brand. Now, this is by no means the best ways. This is by no means the only ways. These are by no means the only ways. These are just how we're doing it and have found it to be effective for us and have gotten it to be our number 16 revenue channel in the last 30 days. When you look at revenue that's coming in from a channel perspective into our brand that I'm about to show you in the last 30 days, this is already number 16. And we basically just started with this. So the first place I would recommend leveraging chatbot technology is with what I call bottom of funnel events. And in our case, this is someone who visited the shopping cart but did not buy. So it's basically all the way at the end of our sales funnel. When someone is super, super interested enough to add a product to the shopping cart and then abandon, we're now using what is called messenger bot retargeting ads. And we've seen a 30% reduction in cost per acquisition. And I'm going to show you exactly how to set this up, exactly how we're using it, and what that actually means. So our sales funnel looks like this. This is quite complex for those of you who are not familiar with sales funnels. I'm going to just run you through it really quickly. For those of you who are listening, this part of it is very visual, so I'll try to do my best to explain it. So we start with a native video advertisement on Facebook, which is designed to get someone to engage content and consume content from our brand without ever leaving the social network, without ever leaving the social medium, which we believe to be the best top of funnel conversion asset. And real quick, the reason we believe that, so my viewpoint is that your brand, I've got a lot of viewpoints if you have not, if you haven't figured that out yet, I'm very opinionated, but my viewpoint is that your brand is simply a collection of conversion assets working in concert with one another to achieve a conversion event. And those conversion assets include sales pages, emails, customer testimonials, videos, like there's all kinds of different conversion assets. And so if we know, if we've established that 67% of people are going to start a purchase decision on one device and finish it on another, if we've established that 33% of people who show interest on a mobile advertisement are going to convert on a desktop, we've established that people are moving to bigger devices to make purchase decisions, then it makes sense to figure out, if we know that most of our sales are coming from the second and third touch point and beyond, to figure out what's the best initial touch point, what's the best top of funnel conversion asset. And in our viewpoint, it is a video, because it gives people the ability to engage with you and consume content on your brand without ever leaving the social environment. It allows you to track who has consumed that video and follow up with them, which is what we do. So we run a video ad on Facebook to people who look like our customers. We then follow up with folks who have consumed 50%, 75%, 95% of that ad and not yet purchased. We then are sending our traffic. All of our sales funnels are very long. And the reason why our sales funnels are very long, that they don't go, you know, advertisement sales page, is because if we know that people need multiple touch points before they're willing to convert, which we have established based on data from Facebook and other data sources, then it makes sense to have your sales funnel have multiple steps so that you can retarget people based at every step. So what we do is we amplify a video that leads to an article, a pre-sell engagement page that's designed to engage someone in a conversation about a topic that they're interested in that is related to a problem or experience, a problem that they have or an experience that they're having that alludes to a solution. I'll say that again because I said it kind of fast, and that solution is your product. So the article that we send people to, and I'll give you a specific example, I sell software. So I amplify a case study article about how that software helps you grow your Shopify business. And then that's a case study that, about a business owner that then alludes to a solution, which is my software. For my makeup brand, I amplify a piece of content that's 5 makeup tips for women over 40. So it's a piece of content that's about an experience that someone is having that alludes to a solution, which is my makeup line for women over 40, right? So I like to stick multiple steps into my sales funnel. Now I'm going to show you a sales funnel that doesn't have so many steps. So back to and I'm saying this stuff a bunch of times for the folks who are listening. So video advertisement, tracking people who consume 50%, 75%, 95% of that video, retargeting them, sending them to our article page. If you click through to the video, you go to the article page. If you don't make it further, if you just land on the article and then bail, we retarget you with more content because you haven't showed interest in our products yet. However, if you click through to our offer sequence, which in our case is a category page on an e-commerce store, we will retarget you with an ad if you bail out of the funnel at that point. If you make it to a product offer page, we're using dynamic advertising. If you make it to the shopping cart, we used to use dynamic product advertising, but now we're doing something different. I'm about to show that. So I just want to get even deeper here. So then there's our checkout sequence where we've got upsells and things like that. Now check this out. We then run an advertisement that's called bot X and not Y. So you remember that I said awareness, retargeting, loyalty, before, during, after. So we think of our brand in these pillars of awareness, which is new people who don't know about us yet, retargeting, which is people who've engaged with us at any step of our sales funnel, and then loyalty. And loyalty doesn't get a lot of love in our community. Everyone talks about traffic and conversion. They don't talk about repeat business. And my viewpoint is that repeat business is really how you build a brand. Half of my business in all of my brands come from people who bought from me in the past. And this is just one strategy that we leverage. So basically what we do is we run a video advertisement to people who bought our top product, but not our second product. So they bought our, you know, most popular, but not our second most popular, or they bought our second most popular and not our third most popular. We're creating dynamic segments of people in our CRM who fit these criteria. We are sending those dynamic segments to Facebook, which is creating audiences of people who've done bought one product and not the other. Then we run an advertisement to them saying, hey, would you be interested in this other product? We probably spend like $3,000 a month on these types of ads and make about 45. So we don't spend a lot, but the ROI on the bot X but not Y advertising is insane. Now let's take it another level deep, because we decided and we talked about the idea of re-engaging people based on behavior. So if someone watches 50% of this video but doesn't buy, we retarget them with an ad that says, hey, are you sure you don't, you know, are you sure that you're not interested in this product? Now think about how many levels deep we are here. We've gone through the awareness phase. We've gone through the retargeting phase. We've created a customer. We've advertised a video to them about a product we think they might be interested in. They've consumed 50% of that more or more of that video and not purchased. We've then retargeted them again in the loyalty pillar with an image ad, because people need multiple touch points before they're willing to make a conversion event, even in the loyalty pillar. So this is, you know, just breaking down our sales funnel for you. Then we are obviously always amplifying content to our subscribers and buyers. So this is just, you know, sort of a side conversation about multi-touch point, multi-step sales funnels. Now, this is how we do things. And we used to do the dynamic product advertising for people who visited our shopping cart but didn't buy, which is simply just like, hey, you looked at this product, but you didn't buy it. Here it is again. I mean, that's really all it is. And so what we switched to doing was running an advertisement that said, hey, we are a big fan of incentivizing people to take action with small discounts. That's Some people argue against discounts. I am not one of those people. I use them everywhere. I use discounts and deadlines consistently across all my brands. And so in this case, we run an ad that says, hey, send us a message to get 10% off. So let me show you how we set this up, and then I'm going to show you the actual ad, and then I'm going to show you the statistics on this ad. So the first thing is that you create a Facebook advertising campaign with the objective of traffic. So Facebook is set up in these three settings. It's campaigns, ad sets, and ads. On the campaign level, you set the objective. On the ad set level, you set the targeting and placement. And on the ad level, you put the actual ad creative. So in this case, the objective for our campaign is the objective of traffic. It's not conversions. It's not event, you know, responses. It's not any other. It's not page likes. It's traffic. That is the objective you need. And the reason you need that objective is because if you want to have a Facebook Messenger pop up when someone clicks on your ad, you need to set that objective. So you set the objective of traffic. It's very important that in the ad set level, so we've now moved from our campaign level where we set the objective of traffic to our ad set level where we're going to set where this advertisement is actually going to show to people. So on the ad set level, we want to set the placement of Facebook feeds. We want to uncheck every other placement, because the only placement that this particular advertisement is allowed is in the Facebook feeds. So if you want to retarget people on all these other platforms who visited your cart and didn't buy, you would set up another campaign, and you would set up in that ad set all the placements that weren't Facebook feeds, and you'd set up your normal retargeting advertisement for people who visited your shopping cart and didn't buy, and you could target them separately. However, we're finding that like 90% of the volume that we were getting in this ad set is on Facebook feeds anyways. So it's not really an issue. Another sort of aside Well, you know, I'll remember it and I'll tell you guys later, but I have a little advertising trick for you that I'll tell you after I'm done with this. I don't want to get too far off topic. So you set Facebook feeds. Then in the ad set level as well, you set the destination where you want someone to go to be called website or messenger. And then obviously on the ad level, we're actually going to set it to messenger. But in the ad set level, the default destination is website or messenger. You just leave that alone. You set your budget, how much you want to spend. And that's going to be dictated by the size of your audience. In our case, we're spending $75 a day on this particular advertising. Then in the ad set level as well, you set the group of people that you want to see this ad, which in our case is people who visited our shopping cart but did not buy in the last 60 days. So, you know, I have a free Facebook training that'll show you how to set up audiences and stuff. But basically, Facebook gives you the ability to build groups of people based on URL events. So people who visited /cart, you can build an audience of them. So you set that. Who you want this to show to, which is the bottom of funnel event, which for you maybe is someone who made it all the way to book a call with you, but then didn't actually do it, or someone who made it to the webinar replay page, but not to the shopping cart. I don't know what the bottom of your sales funnel is, but whatever the like sort of the last two or three steps of your engagement cycle before someone purchases from you is when you're going to want to use this strategy, which I haven't even showed you yet. I'm about to show you. So set your optimization and delivery on the ad set level for link clicks and just leave everything standard. So now we're into the ad level, which is where the actual communication gets set up. So we've set up our campaign for traffic. We've set up our ad set to run on Facebook feeds to target people who visited our cart and didn't buy. Now we're moving into setting up our advertisement. So when we're creating our ad, we want to say an ad with an image or a video, and you can upload your image, you know, whatever image that you want to show. Mm-hmm. Then what we want to do is say Facebook Messenger rather than a website URL. A traditional advertisement on Facebook link that's geared to generate traffic would link to a website URL. In this case, the destination is Facebook Messenger text. And then they give you the option to put some structured JSON, which is essentially the content that is going to pop up when someone sees your advertisement on Facebook. And I will just read what we have in here, just so you, for those of you that are listening, you can hear what people are going to read when they see the ad. So they see
And the way it works is, if I understand you right, someone's going to see this ad that you just showed us how to design, right, yeah, with the image. As soon as they press a button, then they get this text that you're about to read us via Facebook Messenger sent to them. Am I right?
That is correct. And I'm going to show you. It's actually, believe it, the idea that it reduces conversion rate by 30% boggles my mind, because check out the amount of steps that happen. So this is the advertisement that pops up. It's like, hey.
Wait, you know what? Let's read that, what you were about to read, and I interrupted you.
Yeah, it's right here, actually.
Okay, this
is
great.
On this ad. So this is the advertisement. It's in the ad text as well, and it pops up in Facebook Messenger. So it says, hey, limited time discount on Boom products. Reply to this message with the word coupon to get 10% off Boom products, and then there's a link to our store, or ask us any questions you have, and we will ping you back with a response. When they click this ad, which, by the way, these Facebook Messenger ads, the call to action on them says, you know, send message. So when they click that, it pops up a Facebook Messenger box right on their screen that first, it pops up a light box, actually, that says, hey, this, you know, this brand will respond to you in Messenger. As soon as they close that light box, the Messenger pops up and it says the exact same thing that the ad said. Hey, limited time discount, reply to this message with the word coupon, yada, yada.
Okay. And this is about, hang on the screen. I want to make sure I understand why you're doing this. Why do you have the ad on Facebook say the exact same thing as the Facebook Messenger text? And why would you have the ad on Facebook say something like, reply to this message, when there isn't a place to, I would think that people would comment and reply with the word coupon.
You know, here's the thing about setting this up. Mm-hmm. We just saw this technology was available and set it up as soon as it was. We didn't think too much about it. Yeah, could we do this a little better? Could we change the ad text? Could we modify it? Sure, but it was working so well that we just left it alone.
You know? I see. This is just you guys experimenting, and you know what? It worked. I got it. I see.
It literally cut our conversion to math. And man, we do so much volume every day that if we have a win that's this big, we just don't mess with it. We literally are like, oh my God, let's just see what happens. And so now it's been running like this for about, I don't know, 30 or 45 days, and it's just crushing it. So we're just like, well, we could test another ad, but we're also pretty busy. We got a lot of stuff to do. you know, we're just kind of left it.
And again, for anyone who's listening,
smarter from a messaging perspective, probably.
The pop-up would come up the same way it would pop up if your friend or your mom would text you on Facebook Messenger. That little bubble that comes up in the little screen that comes up in the bottom right corner on Facebook, or if they have Facebook Messenger on their phones, which most people do, then their phone will vibrate.
Yes. Okay,
and that's what it looks like. They type in the word coupon,